coming up next. It's a UFC light heavyweight division encounter.
Ready.
Well, these guys have been on each other's radars for quite some time. Tonight, it shall be done. Both guys well-rounded. You think we're getting a kickboxing match tonight or what?
You just don't know, right? You don't know who's going to be able to employ their strategy the way that they need to. This is a close fight on paper, and also in every performance we have seen them put on, these guys seem to be the mirror image of each other.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the counter.
Well, really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC.
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body with that body kick.
All right, single collar tie now. Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes.
And he caught the kick.
All right, so he's doing a nice job to catch the leg. He saw that strike coming and now works it into a takedown. So now he has the fight to the canvas. Let's see what he can do with it. Strong bottom hook here, staying busy. Oh, his opponent squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen.
Pretty good elbow there from the bottom. Gotta stay active off of your back. Lands with the ground and pound.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
All right, he's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground. Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Well, these are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold him,
know when to fold him. Yep, absolutely.
He's having his way with him here. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Less than a minute now to go in round one.
Wow, he actually got the takedown.
45 seconds to go here in round one. Get yourself to the side. 30 seconds now to go in the round. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's gonna start looking to land big shots from the top.
Sound strike on the ground. All right, so we now look back at some of the action from that previous round, DC. A lot.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, second round underway.
Oh, big punch land.
Lands a nice straight punch there. Now we'll see if he can follow it up.
What do you follow up a great punch like this with? I'm excited to see what happens.
Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing.
There, his opponent could be out of here soon, DC.
He's almost done. I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, you don't know whether to run, hide, grab, or wrestle. He's confused. He's as confused as he was on his first test in elementary school.
So we call on the fight stats here. 56 total strikes have now landed for Anthony Smith. Well, you gotta like the accuracy rate as well, landing at a 65% clip, DC, against Johnny Wall. Ooh. And he comes through with a big knee. Now he's got the Muay Thai plug.
Ooh, what a punch.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Oh, big head kick there. All right, so a good job defensively by him here as he raises the guard and prevents any damage.
Shades of James Toney. Always seeing things coming at him. He's such a great defensive fighter.
All right, so he catches the kick there and beautifully counters with the takedown. So a nice job turning that defense into some immediate offense there.
He did a great job of turning his defense into his offense, but you can see that he's done that time and time again. He drilled that exact action, and it worked in this instance.
Man, as he landed a high volume of strikes here in round two, definitely picking up the pace after round one. So he got the message from the corner, and now he is taking control of this second round.
Big powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
All right, both fighters now continuing to try to get a more dominant position. Big right hook coming. It's blocked. Oh, beautiful jab by him there, really taking advantage of what is an obvious edge and reach. Oh, he lands a huge knee to the body. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Single collar tie now. And there comes the separation now. Third round underway. Oh, he lands a huge knee to the body. That's a crippling shot there. Punch coming, it's blocked. Well, just as he did the previous round, continuing to land a high number of strikes here, and he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down. Scary, scary proposition for the opponent. Slips to the ground. Oh!
Now he's on top of him.
13 steps in!
Wow! What a fight!
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught that ultimately appeared as though the outcome was an eventuality. So if you're the referee, you got to protect the fighter, and I thought he did a good job of doing just that. So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the win by TKO. That is one they'll be talking about for quite some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop in this contest at 1:05 of round number 3. Declaring the winner by TKO, Anthony Lionheart.
Well, the celebration is on over there in the corner and nothing subdued about it. They put a lot of time into this training camp and into this performance, and certainly their athlete delivered.
It was a result that they desired. They said, I don't care how this match ends, as long as I'm not standing there waiting on the judges. He got his opponent hurt, and he found the follow-up shots that allowed him to get the TKO.
Pressure.